Hello, Foxtrot64 here again, back with a brand new episode of Let's Play Pokemon Jak and Daxter version, The Precursor Legacy. I'm definitely not using the full title anytime other than that. That is way too long. Okay, I'm not gonna bother talking to the farmer before I do this, but you have to get all the cows, the yak cows, if you will, into their pen. And as anyone who has ever worked with cattle knows, cows are extremely slow and stupid, unless startled. And actually, with a real-life cow, if you punched one in the ass like this, you're putting yourself in some pretty big danger there. Like, even if it's a young one. Hey, where the fuck do you think you're going? Go back! Anyways, I'm gonna just speed the rest of this up while I get these stupid freaking things back into their pen. You're welcome. And now that that has been done, we can go and collect our prize. I wonder what it will be. In a game like this, where it's a collecting quest, what could it possibly be?
Well done, my boy. You actually got those flea bags back into the pen. Now I can sleep in peace. Take this power cell for your trouble.
Of course, it's a power cell. What were you expecting, a Jiggy or something? Come on, man. I like these awkward breakdances that Daxter does when you get a power cell. I kind of miss them, actually. A little bit. But I guess that will be fixed once I play through this game. Again. I don't know if all you guys just missed the last time I uploaded this Let's Play, or tried to anyway. I got like the first two episodes out, but I played this game like all the way through in one day with a friend. Not all that long ago. It couldn't have been. Fuck you! Okay! God, I actually got my ass over here. It couldn't have been like more than maybe a month ago. I played through this game like all the way through with a friend.
Who awakens the Oracle?
So, I'm very much in practice.
One of you has the light with
if that last little display of how in practice I am wasn't enough proof for you.
For the true hero to return. Present to me 120 precursor orbs for each power cell I contain.
Expensive, lady, aren't we? Okay, then. Fine. 120, when everyone else only asks for, like, 90. Which is pretty terrible. Isn't that, like, 33% more? Something like that? I don't know. I don't want to do math while I'm playing a video game. What the? Nice hip thrust there, Daxter. And all the furries went wild. Except for this one. Because I've already gotten over my fangirlism of Daxter years ago. Years. Like, before I even had my current DeviantArt account. Probably before the one that I even had before that. Which is a long ass time ago. Where am I going? Where in the fuck am I going? I'm supposed to- where am I going? Seriously? Well, I guess I could get all the scout flies in Sandover Village, couldn't I? Yeah, I could. I'm going to. Just because. Excuse me, I just had a giant derp. I already have all the scout flies in Sandover Village, so I'm just going to go to the Forbidden Jungle. Oh, I have done so many wonderful, spectacularly intelligent things in this Let's Play already. I are smartest Let's Player ever. like, the best. Okay, this... I had a small rant about this in the last time I attempted this Let's Play, but these orbs right here always bothered me. Notice the title that just said Forbidden Jungle. Notice these orbs down here. Notice those orbs up there. These ones down here are in a farther radius away from Sandover Village and beyond the title of Forbidden Jungle. But once I collect all these, those count for Sandover Village. I thought I had all the ones in Sandover Village already, but I didn't get those ones at the Fire Canyon. But I'll prove it to you right now by going back and getting those. So hang on a second. Can I please? Thank you. Jeez. God, Jack, just grab onto the damn ledge. It's not that hard. Okay, there. See, those counted for Sandover Village. Even though they were, like, way the hell in the Forbidden Jungle, obviously. Beyond orbs that counted for the Forbidden Jungle. So, I don't know, that just always bothered me. It just makes my OCD activate. So, sorry. Had to complain about them. Anyway, here we are in the Forbidden Jungle. There is danger all around in these parts. Especially if you go in the water. I've found that the piranhas are the worst to deal with because in the water, your controls are extremely sluggish. Like, normally, you guys have heard this, me say this before, but normally, water controls do not bother me. I don't care about water levels. They don't bother me. But when the controls are, like, really sluggish and slowed down and it's a serious hindrance to you as a player, then, yeah, by all means, that annoys the hell out of me. Unfortunately, this game admittedly annoys me with the water parts. Few though they are. At least there's, like, not that many of them. And they're pretty much never really for required things, I don't think. Well, technically nothing in this game is really required. There's like almost no power cells that you have to get and cannot avoid. So you could argue that nothing in this game is really required. You kind of have the choice to pick and choose just whichever power cells you want and get only the required amount. If that makes any sense. Anyway. Yeah, there's, like, not very many water parts, luckily, so it's not that bad. Can I... Yeah, thanks. I figured I might as well just get that one the easy way before I break this mirror. And here we go with the towers. I'm gonna just do all these, at once. And do other stuff as I come to it on the way to these. Because these pretty much lead you all around the entire Forbidden Jungle. So, you might as well just do them all in order. Well, you can only do them in order, what the hell. You can't just, like, skip one and then, like, do the one after. You have to do them all in order. But you know what I mean. Just do all these and then do other stuff as I come to them on the way to these. Because these will lead me to all the other stuff. Pretty much. Alright, there's a bunch of orbs over here, and there's a snake that I'm not gonna bother with. Oh, seriously? Come on now. I'm not that terrible. Maybe I am. Okay, now that I got that other thing, let's get these things up here. Please don't fall. Please, please don't fall. That would really suck if you fell right now, Jack. You know that? You would be kind of an asshat. Okay, I didn't fall. Thank God. Now, where was the other one? I, like, cannot see the beam from here. At all. Okay, I guess I'll just find it on my own. Never mind. Fuck off. There's some orbs over there, might as well get those, yeah. And I believe down there is the fisherman who has a bit of a challenge for us. So, We're gonna go and talk to him after we get these orbs. There you are, Mr. Fisherman.
What do you have in the basket?
Nothing to talk about. Them monsters patrolling the ocean took a bite out of me fishing rig. And now they're gobbling up me catch. No matter what I try.
Ugh, there is almost nothing worse than fish breath.
Woo! Maybe it's your breath.
You think you can do better? Try scooping up river fish with a tiny net. I'll give you a power cell if you can catch 200 pounds of them critters. And then I'll let you and Shrimp here use my speedboat to get to Misty Island. He's want to try the challenge.
You know, this little minigame type thing is fun, but there's a couple of things about it that really piss me off. First of all, he purposefully gives you a small net, thereby hindering you from doing your best. Second, he doesn't allow you to miss 20 pounds. So even though he could not catch anything, if you happen to have like 199 pounds of fish and then you miss just that 1 pound that sets you over the 20 line, he counts you as sucking and you have to restart.
There are two types of good fish to catch.
1 pound fishies and 5 pound fishies. Nothing in between.
If you miss 20 pounds of good fish, then I'm gonna take me net back from you.
Which is stupid.
There are poisonous eels in this river. Catch even a one of them boogers, and you'll poison the whole darn catch.
See, now that makes sense. What doesn't make sense is the freaking you can't miss 20 pounds rule. That's dumb. Like, I'm sorry. I know that's to make it more challenging, so maybe from a game designer's point of view I can see that, but I still think the limit should be at least, like, maybe a little bit higher. How about 30 pounds? Because, yeah, I mean, it's a little bit tough. Almost nobody gets this on the first try, too. Because, like, the controls are a little bit sensitive and over-responsive in a way, which they have to be to switch from one side to the other in an instant to catch some of these fish, and I just missed one. But yeah, this is definitely challenging for beginning game stuff, and you almost have to miss some of these fish. I mean, did you see? There was no way that I could have gotten some of those in time. See? Oh my god. See, some of these are, like, I swear, impossible to get all of them. Like, there's just no way in hell you could get every single fish, because they're, like, spread so the hell far apart. That it's just, I don't see how it's plausible. So, yeah. I mean, this is fun, don't get me wrong, but a couple of things about it definitely do piss me off. At least at this part where it goes, like, extremely fast, you never really have to switch from one side all the way to the other, I've noticed. Maybe someone has. Oh, I did it! Yay! Good!
Not bad for a couple of landlubbers.
Thanks.
Here's the power cell I promised.
Thanks.
And you can use my boat at the village dock whenever you like.
Yeah, fuck you. Okay, thank you for the power cell, but fuck you. Fuck you and your minigame. It kind of makes me mad. Not gonna lie. And this is pretty great. He just stands there with his mouth closed and laughs eternally. Never ceases laughter. It's a little bit tragic, really. See what I mean about your controls being, like, a bit sluggish in the water as compared to on land? I think the last time I played this, it was a bit more sluggish-ier than that, but yeah. And especially, like, how slow you walk in the water and how slow this guy swims. Oh my god, he swims so damn slow. Go away. I don't want your tentacle prawns right now. And with that many spikes, it looks like it would be painful. Okay, I'm not gonna grab the blue eco just yet. Oh, I just got both of those things at the same time. Now I'm gonna grab the blue eco and see if I can run back to where that thing was over here. Not entirely sure if that's how you're supposed to get that one, but that is how I got it, so whatever. I suppose you could go up there on that ledge and get that, like, vent that has the blue eco too, but just so that I can swim a little bit faster and grab some of these orbs a little bit easier. This guy swims so slow. And like the underwater controls. Oh my god. Above water is bad enough. Under the water, oh my god. It's just so bad. Oh, I'm glad I don't have to do that like barely ever at all. Cause if I did, if there was like whole underwater portions, I wouldn't do it. I simply would not. And I'm sure anyone else who's played this could probably agree with me. Oh hey, I've already been up here. Okay. I'm gonna go over onto there then, where this blue eco vent is, and activate the thing. There we go. Now I have a half bridge. But I'm also gonna grab these orbs up here. Yeah, might as well. Well, I have the blue eco powers to do so effortlessly. Okay. Oh my god. If I would have dropped off of that, that would have sucked. Okay. So, activate that, but I'm not gonna go there just yet. I'm gonna go up here. Because there is stuff up out here. This reminds me of, like, the beginning of Jak 2. That one part where you have to jump around a building like that. But, like, the platforms fall out from under you when you land on them. God, I love Jak 2. But my favorite of the series is by far Jak 3. Because Jak 3 was just fucking amazing. This is one of those rare trilogies where, like, every game gets better the later it is. That doesn't happen very often in gaming. But this is definitely one of those. Like, they just keep improving on it. And then they make the mistake of making a fourth game called The Lost Frontier. I'm really sorry. I hated The Lost Frontier. I couldn't even finish the game. It was so bad. Like, that new company or whoever that took it over, they had no idea what they were doing. I'm not gonna say they completely fucked it up, but they did fuck it up kinda bad. Yeah. Every other game in the Jak and Daxter series, fine, great games. I love them. Even Daxter on the PSP and Jak X Combat Racing, great. No problem. Lost Frontier. Sucks. So bad. Okay. Last thing that we're gonna do in this video. There is a way to turn on that blue eco vent that, Kira was talking about. And it's down over here. And it just requires some simple jumps. Which are my worst enemy. Just about. So, hopefully I won't die. Oh my! That mini heart attack when you press the X button, but it doesn't jump, but you save yourself anyway. That seems to happen to me a lot, pressing the X button and it not jumping. And I know the carpenter should not blame her tools, but it really is an issue. It's all glowy and shiny and shit! Ermagerd! Now we can open up the dirr! The dirr! The dirr can be herbed! And we can get all these herbs! Well, not herbs, but orbs. Oh, fuck. So that's this. Goodbye.